You're listening to Saturday Morning Media. And now, back to our show.
Hey, Attraction Checklist fans, how would you like to get the attraction audio from each of these episodes without all the pesky talking before and after? Well, now you can. The attraction audio from each Attraction Checklist episode will be available exclusively to the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons who pledge at any level. Head on over to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media today to find out how to pledge. And thank you for your support.
Hello, everyone. Paul here from Window to the Magic, the ultimate Disney audio adventure. And you're about to listen to Attraction Checklist. Enjoy!
My name is Grant Pachoco, and I invite you to join me on my quest to learn about and experience every Disney park attraction I possibly can. This is Attraction Checklist.
Welcome to Attraction Checklist. This time we've got something very special for you. The return of the Main Street Electrical Parade to Disneyland Park. The audio for this episode was recorded on January 19th, 2017, as the parade made its return to its birthplace at a special premiere event. The parade is currently described in the guide by saying, "Catch this classic nighttime parade filled with fanciful floats and toe-tappin tunes for a limited time. It fades away June 18th, 2017. As this is a parade, it's open to all ages and there is no height requirement. Though if you want to see the parade from up front, you'll have to snag a viewing spot along the parade route early." Now, before we experience this spectacular festival pageant of nighttime magic and imagination, here are five fast facts about the Main Street Electrical Parade. 1. The Main Street Electrical Parade debuted at Disneyland on June 17, 1972, and it ran at the park until November 25, 1996. 2. The parade was created to be a West Coast version of the electrical water pageant that has run at Walt Disney World in Florida since October 26, 1971. The water pageant features barges with light-up screens depicting a sea serpent, jumping dolphins, a turtle, and more. Now, instead of traveling down Main Street at the Magic Kingdom, these floats travel on barges across the Seven Seas Lagoon. 3. According to then-director of show development Ronald Mitziker, all 500,000 light bulbs in the original parade needed to be hand-tinted, which required dipping each one in the appropriate colored paint. 4. The Main Street Electrical Parade is known for its iconic music. The underlying theme is called Baroque Hoedown and was originally created by early synthesizer pioneers Jean-Jacques Perret and Gershon Kingsley. And 5. The Main Street Electrical Parade was the first in Disney park history to use an automated parade show control program. This allowed the parade route to have different radio-activated zones that allowed for float-specific music and sound to be triggered as the floats passed through those zones. This is a technique still used in Disney parks today. Now it's time to sit back and enjoy the Main Street Electrical Parade as it returns to Disneyland for the first time in over 20 years. Watching the parade with me today is the man who inspired this very podcast you're listening to, Window to the Magic's Paul Berry. And after the parade, we discuss our thoughts on this returning attraction. Once again, this is a binaural recording, so if you have headphones, put them on now as we enjoy the Main Street Electrical Parade.
Thank you. nor the Cheshire Cat. Very jealous of such enormous smiles. You know, I've often seen a cat without a smile. Oh, but I've never seen a smile without a cat. Oh, I do hope you won't be disappearing as quickly as the Cheshire Cat.
Don't know what color it is, but it's green and shiny. And all the
Well, I'm here with Paul Berry of the Window to the Magic podcast, and we just watched the premiere, the return of the Main Street Electrical Parade.
Hey, you are correct. We did, and what a sight it was. It has been way too long.
It absolutely has. Do you have fond memories of the parade before this?
Fond does not even start to express what I have over this parade. I remember as a kid seeing this when my family would come down, and one of my greatest memories is starting out at Small World and listening to the announcement. Listening to the announcement, and then I would run to where they're going to do the next announcement. And then from then on, I would just go all the way until I was in Town Square. And then I would finally hear the announcement and watch the parade. That's how much I love this parade.
Yeah, I love this parade a lot. One of my fondest memories is when I was a kid, we came once with the family, and I think my aunt had a video camera and videotaped the parade.
Wow.
And I have this, she was must have been right next to a speaker. And you and I were talking earlier about the Blue Fairy used to be at the front of the parade.
Right.
And you could just hear the music, and you see the Blue Fairy coming towards the camera. And then my dad, at the top of his lungs, goes, "You want me to wear what? Are you going to plug that in?" And it that just be as silly as that is, that became a memory of the parade whenever I'd see the Blue Fairy.
Nice.
Picturing my dad dressed as the Blue Fairy.
That's right. Your dad sitting on top of that, because that had to be 20 feet tall.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was a great float, and I'm sorry it's not around anymore.
Yeah, what did you think of the new Tinkerbell float?
It was pretty. It was very nice, and they kept with the style.
Yeah.
Which is good. So it's okay, and the music as it passed by fit in just fine as well. So that was good.
Yeah. And my other story about the Mesa Little Parade is when I worked here, I actually got to drive the back end of Elliot.
You did not.
I did. So that is one of my favorite floats, I think, of all time. It's a big dragon.
I'm going to call you Grant Dragon Butt Bachoco.
There you go.
On.
Dragon Butt Bachoco. That's my new nickname. I'm going to have shirts made. And I love, like, the little thing that they do with that float where he turns invisible.
Yeah.
And they just turn the lights on.
Razzle dazzle. Yeah. And unfortunately, they didn't do that in front of us. I always love that. Pete will get the entire crowd to yell razzle dazzle. And when they do that, he just very discreetly turns the switch. But Elliot literally disappears. It's dark and all the lights go out.
Yeah.
So it's awesome.
Well, are you going to see this multiple times now that it's back at Disneyland?
That's a serious question here. I'm coming back tomorrow. I'll probably be here Saturday, Sunday. You know, I'm going to show up after work because I work just down the street. You bet.
All right. Well, Paul, thank you so much for being on the show. I appreciate it.
You bet. Thanks for having me.
And where can people, people should know where Window the Magic is, but just in case there's an odd person who doesn't.
I always tell people to look on the internet.
There you go. That's a good place to find it.
You bet. Windowtothemagic.com.
Do you agree or disagree with Paul and I's thoughts on the Main Street Electrical Parade? Join the conversation over at the Attraction Checklist Facebook page at facebook.com/attractionchecklist. Also, for sources and links for this episode, visit our website at attractionchecklist.com. What attraction should I go on next? Send me an email over at hello@saturdaymorningmedia.com, or you can let me know via Twitter, where my username is ToasterBoy, or post on the aforementioned Attraction Checklist Facebook page. Attraction Checklist is a production of Saturday Morning Media and made possible by the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons who've gone to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up a monthly donation for as little as $1 a month. Huge thanks to Shea Stewart, Mer Lafferty, Jeff Peterson, Dale Gadania, Steven Staver, Jackie Klimo, Melissa Crawford, Chuck, Dave Slusher of the Evil Genius Chronicles, Mike Coughlin, Dorothy Pachoco, John D., Kathy Crawford, Brian Greer, Carrie Whitney, Chuck Tomasi, Chris Foster, Stephen Ng, Clinton of ComedyForecast.com, Vicky DeVries, Mike Wobshall, Twitter user Butzengear, a.k.a. Wildcat, Eve Cunning, Mike Hamilton, Gaston Morineau, Reed Loveland, Ivan Asquith, Vanessa Whitney, Nancy McCarthy, Janine Lee, and Peggy Etra. If you'd like to support this show and get the exclusive attraction audio for every episode and support the other content from Saturday Morning Media, become a patron. Head on over to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up your monthly donation today. You can also tell a friend about the show or leave the show a review on iTunes. And while you're over in iTunes, be sure to click that subscribe button. That way more people will find out about the show. Thank you so much for listening. We'll talk to you next time on Attraction Checklist. Attraction Checklist is copyright 2017 Saturday Morning Media, Grant Pachoco, executive producer, all rights reserved. www.saturdaymorningmedia.com.
You've been listening to Saturday Morning Media. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.